In our previous video, we learned about square and square roots. We've already known that the square roots operation is the inverse of the squaring operation. For example, when you square 5, you get 25, and its square root is 5. Similarly, 7 squared is 49, therefore the square root of 49 is 7. These special numbers, like 25 and 49, are called perfect squares. Just like in life, some are perfect and some are not. A perfect square can be expressed as the product of two integers of equal value. For instance, 9 is a perfect square, because it's the result of 3 multiplied by 3. Now, to determine whether a number, namely 134, is a perfect square, check if it can be expressed as the product of two equal integers. In this case, 134 is not a perfect square, because it falls between two perfect squares, 121 from 11 square and 144 from 12 square, and therefore not an integer. The square root is a decimal number, 11.576. What about the numbers 27, 73, 188, 362, 527, and 903? Are any of them perfect squares? Answer it without a calculator in under 5 seconds. Remember, in the world of perfect squares, the unit digit, or the last digit, follows specific patterns: 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, or 9. However, it doesn't work in the opposite way, as seen with 79, which isn't a perfect square despite ending in 9. So, always keep in mind that if the unit digit is 2, 3, 7, or 8, the number is definitely not a perfect square. This rule applies even to larger numbers. For instance, consider the number 1,679,743. Since it ends with a 3, it's not a perfect square, which means no two integers of equal value will ever give the product as 1,679,743. All perfect squares have two sets of square roots. Consider a perfect square 81. The product 81 can be obtained by multiplying two sets of integers, 9 times 9 and minus 9 times minus 9. A positive value of 9 multiplied by itself will yield 81, just like a negative value of 9 will. Similarly, we can say that the square roots of 49 are minus 7 and plus 7. Now, let's put your knowledge to the test. Can you quickly determine if the following numbers are perfect squares? 256, 625, 729, 972. Rely on the patterns we discussed earlier. Leave your answers in the comments below. If you enjoyed our perfect squares lesson, be sure to subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out on our next exciting lesson on how to determine the square root of a number. Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content.